This is the Math 2 lesson summary video for the lesson entitled Going Back in Time. In the second lesson in Unit 5, titled Going Back in Time, the purpose of this lesson is for students to be able to use negative exponents as input values for an expression, be able to interpret an expression given within a context, and to be able to rewrite expressions in a slightly different way using the properties of exponents. So if you recall in Math 1, Unit 2, we started discussing the properties of exponents. So if you want to pause this video, I've included the properties of exponents here, which we may need to use in this lesson. For example, when you have the same base as a number and you are multiplying, you add the exponents. When you have the same base as a number and you are dividing, you subtract the exponents, so on and so forth. These are all important. Another one we might need for this lesson is when we have a negative exponent. When we have a negative exponent, we can rewrite that as 1 divided by the number to that power, x, so that the exponent becomes positive when you bring it into the denominator. In lesson 1 of this unit, you recall that we were trying to figure out how many bacteria there would be at a certain time in the future. So for example, in lesson 1, we started with the same amount of bacteria as lesson 2, 300. But we were trying to find how many bacteria there would be at 20 minutes in the future or 25 minutes in the future. So in the previous lesson, we did start with the same number of bacteria as this lesson. We started with 300. But for example, we were trying to figure out how many bacteria there would be at a third of an hour. So we noticed in the previous lesson that the exponent of 1/3 told us how many minutes in the future, or helped us to figure out how many minutes in the future we would need to figure out how many bacteria there are. So what we're asked to do in number 1, we still know that the bacteria is doubling, and if we look at our equation that's provided, we see that it is being multiplied by 2 to a power. So from lesson 1, it's already filled in that after 1 hour we would have 600 bacteria, after 2 hours we would have 1200 bacteria. So students in class were given some time to take a look and see how they could figure out 1 hour ago, how we could figure out how many bacteria there were. So students came up with different ideas, but one way that students tried to figure out an hour ago is they took the 300, which is the initial bacteria, and they actually divided it by 2. So when we take 300 and we divide by 2, we get 150. So they figured out there should be 150 hours. So then they took the 150, which is the new amount of bacteria, and divided in half. And the reason they divided in half is they said that, well, we're multiplying by 2 to go into the future each time. So if we're going in to the previous time, we would need to do the inverse or opposite, which would be dividing by 2. Oops, and I'm sorry, that should be a 75, not a 150. So if we are at 75 bacteria, again they took the 75 and they divided by 2, and they obtained 37.5 bacteria. In number 3, we examined if all of the expressions written above simplified to the same number of bacteria. So what we discussed in class was that when we start with the 300, the exponent, if it is negative, we figured out that that meant that this was 2 hours ago. So in the first one, this represents how many bacteria are present 2 hours ago. When we looked at the second expression, based on our information, some students said, well, we could rewrite the denominator, bring it up to the numerator and rewrite it as 2 to the negative 2 power. And that is the same expression then than the first expression given. Some other students said that we could just take the 300 and divide it by 4, and we would get the same answer as the previous. And so we would get 75 bacteria if we go back up to our table and we have a negative 2 exponent, that we would get 75 bacteria. And the last expression that's given, it shows us that we're taking 300 and we're first dividing by 2. So when we take 300 and divide by 2, that's the same thing that we did in the first example, number 1. We would be left with 150 bacteria. And if we take that 150 and divide it again by 2, we would be left with 75. So to answer this question, yes, they all simplify to 75 bacteria. And we discussed in class how this represents negative time in each of the scenario above. What is really important about lesson 2 is that you're able to look at an exponent, whether it's negative or positive, and determine what that information means with regards to a context. So if we look at 4a, we're still starting with the same number of bacteria, which we see here, 300. And our exponent in this case is negative 1/4, which we see here. What's important to know is that when that exponent is negative, we are going back in time. If you look at c, we can see that the exponent is positive. That means that we are going into the future. So in A, in class we discussed that what's happening in A is we're going back in time, and we're going back 1/4 of an hour. So I'm going to write that down here. So this represents the number of bacteria. A 1/4 of an hour ago. And you may be able to just do that in your head, but if I go back to my calculator and I try and figure out 60 minutes in an hour divided by 4, that means at 15 minutes ago, how many bacteria there would be. So in parentheses, I'll just write 15 minutes ago. Okay. In B, the interesting thing is that we have a power to a power. And so we're bringing in some of our properties here. When we have a power to a power, one way that we could simplify that is to multiply. So we start with 300 bacteria. And when we multiply 2 to the 1/3 times 3/1, that actually simplifies to 2 to the 1st power. So what that means is that it represents the number of bacteria after 1 hour. And we can see that because my exponent is 1, it is positive. That means that we're trying to find how many bacteria in the future. So you could probably guess on C that we're talking about how many bacteria in the future because our exponent is positive. And if we look at 24, that's telling us how many bacteria we're trying to find after 24 hours. So this one represents the number of bacteria present after 24 hours. Okay, so the next piece of this is also discussing how we can just calculate that. Since C is in the future, what we can do is we can figure out when I multiply 300 times 2 to the 24th power, I know that in 24 hours, there will be 5,033,164,800 bacteria. So to summarize today's lesson, you should be able to look at an expression and explain the possible meaning in a context. So in the first one on the left, we start with 100 bacteria. And if we use our properties and multiply, we'll be left with 2 to the 4 halves power. And if we simplify 2 to the 4 halves power, we get 2 squared. When we look at that exponent, it is positive. So in this situation, we are saying how many bacteria would be present 2 hours in the future. And the expression on the right, we're starting with 100. And so we can already see that our exponent is negative. So we can already determine that this would be 2 hours in the past. Another way to write the expression on the right is we can keep our 100 times, if we use our properties of exponent and bring the negative exponent to the denominator, it would be 1 divided by 2 squared. And we can simplify that as 100 times a fourth. If we want to actually answer those questions, we can type in our expression 100 times 2 squared. So we know that 2 hours in the future, we would have 400 bacteria in this scenario. Likewise, if my exponent is no longer positive, but it is negative, that means we're finding how many bacteria are 2 hours in the past, and there would be 25. In this lesson, we also did look at the fact that we can take the starting number of bacteria, which was in this example 100, and divide by 2, and divide by 2 twice to get the same answer from the past. If you need more help on the Ready, Set, Go homework for this task, please remember to check the student support site.